x1 x1 n mod square. So it is psi a conjugate x1 psi a and dx1. So this is the x and n state a. Clear? Means now I will not write as x1 because I have assigned it a state a. Same variable. And this one is same variable but state is b. Then I will come to this one. Psi b x1 x1. So this is actually the b state. And this one is the a. Expectation value of this. Now these are not squares because this is just one r. Clear? The variable. And then I come here. Now this is psi a x1 conjugate x1 and then psi b x1 dx1. So this is like x and the state is a b because it's a combined state. And then this term, it is x and b a. And then this term, okay, this term, okay, I have forgotten one conjugate here. So this one is conjugate. Okay, what about this one? X and b a. This one is x and a b. Now write them all in one equation here and we will have, this is the x1, x2 expectation value is equal to half, then xa multiplied with xb, xa multiplied with xb, then plus xb multiplied with xa, xb multiplied with xa, then another plus here, and we are having xab multiplied with xba, and plus xba with xab. Clear? So I wrote all the terms here, and now look here. I find the expectation value xa and then the expectation value xb. Here I find first the expectation value xb and then xa. So these two are the same things. Just multiplication of this. Mean I can write xab, this xb and then ba, they are the same. I can switch them. There is no problem with them. They are just the expectation values. So I can write, it will become 2 times xa xb. 2 will cancel here and I will have that x1 x2 this is equal to xa and xb. And then look here, this is xab and this is xba, ab and ba. This one I can write as ab and ba, right? This one I can write, like I write this one earlier and this one later. So this is again becoming 2 times xab xba and 2 will cancel here. So plus xab and xba. Clear? Now a question. Can I write this ab like this and this ba like this AB. What's wrong here? Because look here, what we have got AB. We have got this AB. If I want to write this BA, then it means that this will become conjugate and this will become non-conjugate. It means when they switch with one another, then conjugate, how it will become psi B conjugate and psi A when you take another conjugate of this one. Clear? You got it?
Yes.
Means if I want to write this AB like BA, then how it will be possible? If I write this one psi B conjugate and then multiply with psi A. Clear? This is if, let me write this one here. This, if I write x, okay, here we are already having this thing. We are already having this thing. AB and then BA. Here, psi B is conjugate. Psi A is non-conjugate. Here, psi A is conjugate and psi B is non-conjugate. So, if I want to make this one like this one, I will have to take another conjugate of this one. It means that I will write this thing is x A plus, sorry, x A into x B. XA into XB plus AB XAB, and then this X I write is AB, then it will be conjugated. Clear? It will be conjugated, means it will be the other way, and then I can write that XAB, X1, X2 is equal to XA, XB, and plus XAB mod square. Clear? XAB mod square, because this is AB multiplied with AB, so it is mod square of this thing. So what result I got? Now I will, means I found x1 squared, I found x2 squared, I found x1 and x2. Now it is time to put this in x1 minus x2 whole squared. So the result is x1 minus x2 whole square, and for x1 square I will put this value, and for x2 square I will put this value, right? And now look here, when x1 square will be added with x2 square, this square plus this square, what it will be? Half half will become 1. So I can write that this is x square a plus x square b. These two here. Then minus 2 times the value this one. So minus 2 times this value, minus 2 and x A, X, B, and minus 2, and this value, which is X, A, B, mod squared. If you look at the distinguishable particle, this value, x square a, x square b, and minus 2 x a b. It is here. But for the identical bosons, I got an additional value. Clear? I got an additional value. And that additional value is minus 2xab. So when the particles become identical, then the expectation value of the square of separation comes out to be with n additional term. Clear?
Yes.
And now we will consider the case of identical fermions. So what will be the difference between them? The difference between them will be, here will be only minus. So do all this calculation with only minus. And what we will get? We will get here
plus.
Clear? This, all the difference will come out here. Then we will get plus here. So for the identical means when it will be case 3. Case 2 was for identical fermion bosons, and case 3 will be for identical fermions. Identical fermions. And identical fermions, this will come out to be x1 minus x2 expectation value square is equal to x square a plus x square b minus 2x a x b, and this will become plus 2 and x a b mod square. So it is plus here, this is minus here, this is having 0 here for that one, that additional value. Mean the difference between all of them. When distinguishable particles, we are having this thing. When particles become identical, we are having this additional term. When the particles are bosons, we are having this term is minus, means subtracting from it. And when we are having the identical fermions, this term is adding up here. Now look at the value here. That what is actually x1 minus x2? x1 is one spatial variable, one coordinate, and x2 is another variable, space variable. x1 minus x2 is their separation. Right? This is one spatial variable, this is another spatial variable. With minus means with minus, what you are doing, you are finding their relation. For the distinguishable particle, the x1, x2 value remains fixed. Clear? Means this value remains fixed here. You will have to calculate this one. When they become identical bosons, then from that distinguishable situation, for the identical bosons, the value is additional term is subtracted from them. So their separation gets closer. Right? And when we come to the identical fermions, additional value comes in, means plus this one. So the separation is this one, for example, for the distinguishable particle. When it comes to the identical bosons, one term is subtracting from them. So the separation becomes less. And when they become fermions, another term is added to them. So they are. So it's just behaving like attraction, repulsion. Clear?
Yes.
And it behaves like that there is some exchange force between them. Means in their states, the fermions are trying to repel each other. While in those states, the bosons are trying to attract each other. While distinguishable particles remains the same spacing. Clear? Understand this one like this, that we are having state A and state B. Okay? State A, state B. And this is their separation. And when it comes to the, this is for the distinguishable particles. Clear? You can write here like this term, like D here, distinguishable. Then this whole term from here to here is the distinguishable term, and plus for the fermions and minus for the bosons. When in these states you put the boson particles, what happens? The states behaves like they are getting closer to each other. And when you put fermions in them, the states behave like they are going apart from each other. Means this is their separation. Clear? You got it?
Yes, sir.
Because plus term is here. The separation is increased here. And minus term here, the separation is decreased here. So it is a kind of force between them, that they are getting closer in the case of bosons and getting farther apart in case of fermions. And this force we term is an exchange force. And we know that we haven't calculated any force between them. This is just a separation between them. Right? We have just calculated the separation between them. So in reality, this is not a force, but it is a geometrical consequence. You are changing the geometry. You are changing the nature of particles. And when you change the nature of particles, you are having attraction and repulsion as compared to the distinguishable particles.